Welcome dear student, let's start modes of nutrition. Today my topic is modes of nutrition, class 7. Okay, process of obtaining foods is called nutrition. Modes of nutrition in plant, we can classify nutrition in plant autotrophic modes of nutrition and heterotrophic modes of nutrition. Okay, autotrophic modes of nutrition. Green plant absorbs carbon dioxide from air and water from soil. With the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, this converting material into food. This process is called photosynthetic. That means green plants have ability to prepare food for themselves. Such plants are called autotrophs. The kind of nutrition in which an organism prepares its own food is called autotrophic modes of nutrition. Example are all green plants, blue grain, algae, etc. Now, let's talk about heterotrophic modes of nutrition. Plants which cannot produce their own food, and so these are dependent on green plants or other organisms for their foods. Such modes of nutrition is called heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition could be parasitic, saprophytic, symbiotic. Okay. Parasitic nutrition. Cactus. Some plants like cactus, locally called amber bell, grows over other plants and obtain and nutrients from it. Such plants are called parasite. And the plant over which close and obtain nutrient is called host. Such mode of nutrition, organism obtain nutrients from other organism food, is called as parasitic nutrition. Okay. Example, cauliflower, rafflesia, etc. Saprophytic nutrition. Some plants, such as mushroom, secrete digestive juices on that part of the plant and enable to consume. Organism obtain nutrients from dead and decaying organism substance is called saprophytic nutrients. And the organism which have saprophytic nutrients are called saprotrophs. Other examples are bleach moths, rhizopes or mucus, and pin moths. Food like pickles and materials like leather. It's fine. Because of saprophyte such as fungi. Symbiotic nutrition. There are some organisms which live together, like they share shelter and foods. In science, symbiotic relationship. For example, rhizobium bacteria and leguminous plant such as peas, moons, beans, etc. The leguminous plants, like the bacteria, live in roots and also provide food to it. On the other hand, the rhizobium bacteria convert nitrogen present in soil used by the plant. In this way, both are beneficial to each other. Another example of symbiotic nutrition is algae and fungi. It is called lichens. Fungi share shelter, waters, and other nutrients to algae. In turn, algae offer foods prepared by photosynthetic to the fungi. Insectivory nutrition. Traps and pitcher plants. They colorful, attract to insect others them. part of the body such as lips into trap organs such as pitcher, which help for catching the insect. The hairs present in the pitcher hold the insect. Tajnat later escape. With the help of digestive enzymes, they digest the food and obtain nutrients from it. The question is, why do they need to eat insects? Well, the reason is quite simple. There is need of complex matter in the form which can be used for the plants. The job obtained by bacteria such as rhizobium bacteria. The process of conversion of complex nitrogen matter into simple form ammonia that can be used in plant is called nitrogen fixation or nitrification. Because of the acidic soil, the process should not be completed. In substance, and some other sources of food by the insect. I hope you got good knowledge in topics.